My name is Don Schuessler. I'm a pediatrician in upstate New York. It's a small community, and I'm the only pediatric provider now. Respiratory syncytial virus is a common childhood illness. It's been shown for years and years that most children acquire the infection by the second year of life. Thankfully, most children don't get very sick with their RSV, but every year I take care of children that get quite ill. I see several hundred children with RSV in a season. I have to put a handful into the hospital. And every once in a while, a child gets very sick and needs to have pediatric intensive care and even intubation because it can be such a negative effect on the respiratory system for the children. There's about 4 million cases of RSV every year in the United States. But it's not just children who get RSV, adults get RSV also. This past summer, I got a viral respiratory infection, and then I started feeling worse and worse. 3 days, 4 days, 6 days. Finally, I went and had a nasal swab. I had RSV. The understanding is that as you get older, you're more at risk of having the more serious complications of RSV infection. The respiratory syncytial virus, unfortunately, makes some elderly people terribly sick. Mine was not nice. I was very uncomfortable and miserable for about 10, 12 days. I got better, but a lot of people die from it. My understanding is in the US, about 17,000 adults die from RSV every season. One of the real concerns I have is that I see these young children who are at high risk and they interact with the rest of their families, their parents, their grandparents, some of their great-grandparents. So I'm really concerned for some of those children that the elderly who will have RSV and perhaps not be very sick can give it to their young grandchildren or great-grandchildren and cause them to be very sick. So if we can prevent the adults from having RSV, we can also protect our youngest children. So it's a big problem, and figuring out how to address that and try to help those folks and prevent serious disease in adults is a real challenge for us as we move ahead into the next number of years. If we can address RSV in a way that's helpful and prevents bad outcomes for not just the seniors that may acquire it, but younger children, it would be a really wonderful thing.